Right, Tully out there, champs, and welcome to the show. And guess what? We're getting a new Thunderbolt. It has been leaked. Yes, Thunderbolt 5 is coming out. This is everything you need to know about it. And where does that leave AMD and Apple? Because we know the Intel laptops will get it. We'll talk about that later. Also, there's a next generation USB coming out. Some are calling it USB 5. I'll just call it next gen USB. And the main thing about the next gen USB-C is it can do 250 watts power delivery. So we'll keep that in mind in a sec. But when it comes to like Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4, one of the reasons I sort of stuck with Intel, and I was very tempted to get an AMD laptop, believe me, very, very tempted. But when they brought out the 11th gen CPUs, had PCI Express 4 and Thunderbolt 4, I'm totally invested in Thunderbolt, not just for eGPU. I never use an eGPU. It's mainly for docking, Thunderbolt devices. You can have 10 gig networking with Thunderbolt, fast storage. It's just the killer port that does everything. And when Thunderbolt 4 came out, I was very disappointed because really it should have just been Thunderbolt 3 point something. Thunderbolt 4 is just Thunderbolt 3 with everything implemented. What happened is PC manufacturers were picking and choosing what they would put in their Thunderbolt. Some would put power delivery, some wouldn't. Some would use 2 lanes, some would use 4 lanes, whatever. They just chose whatever they wanted. So with Thunderbolt 4, they just aligned everything together and they put minimum specs on everything. So that means they had to be 40 gigabits per second, which in reality gave you 32 gigabits per second, the VTT-based DMA protection on by default, which some Thunderbolts didn't have. And that was that whole thing of, oh, you can have your Thunderbolt hack. No, you can't if you have this DMA protection on. Has to have it with Thunderbolt 4. Also, 11th gen CPUs, they had Thunderbolt 4 built into the CPU rather than going through what we used to call sort of the South Bridge. Using a discrete Thunderbolt controller, it was built into the CPU now. You could go straight into the CPU, straight into the memory. A much better solution with Thunderbolt 4, you could do that. But there was nothing extra in Thunderbolt 4 over Thunderbolt 3 other than you could wake from a hub. That was it. So now we're getting Thunderbolt 5. It has been leaked. Someone inadvertently took a photo of a screenshot that said, yes, Thunderbolt 5 is coming. Will obviously be coming to Intel laptops and it is going to be over USB-C. So I expect it should have 250 watts of power, given that the next gen USB is going to have 250 watts of power. So that means on gaming laptops that use 250 watts or less, we should be able to use USB-C. Woof. That's what I'm talking about. But not only that, now Intel systems have PCI Express 4, which means running at the same 4 lanes that Thunderbolt 3 and 4 does, we can get double the bandwidth through PCI Express 4. So that means we can have 80 gigabits per second. That is double the bandwidth compared to 40 gigabits per second. So Thunderbolt 5 will be twice the bandwidth. That pretty much means most of the bottleneck gone. If you're using like an eGPU, most of the bottleneck will be gone. So you'll get all your performance out of your GPU. And as I said before, we should be getting 250 watts of power as well. So that is just going to be amazing. Of course, it's going to be built into the Intel CPUs. You won't need discrete, you know, chip for this Thunderbolt. Maybe there's some Ultrabooks that are actually using PCI Express 4 to connect their Thunderbolt. I don't know. I'm not an engineer. Maybe there is. Maybe there can be some sort of BIOS update to increase the bandwidth of some of those laptops. I don't know. That's just pure speculation. I don't think so. I think you're going to need one of the new CPUs with Thunderbolt built into it. Alder Lake, maybe at the end of the year, definitely early next year. Hopefully they do something with the display compression too. So we'll be able to use like, you know, the XDR Apple display with that one Thunderbolt cable. But I can't wait for Thunderbolt 5. Will Microsoft have it on their Surface products? Yeah, nah. I will not be holding my breath for that. With Apple and AMD, I think next gen USB, so USB 5 should incorporate the next Thunderbolt as well, I assume. If that's the case, of course, Apple will use it. They'll go to, you know, next gen USB, USB 5, and have Thunderbolt 5. AMD are not even on USB 4. So I would expect the next gen Ryzen should be USB 4 at least. So they should have Thunderbolt built in, hopefully. But will they go to the next generation USB 5 and have Thunderbolt 5? I don't know. So anyway, I thought I'd keep you in the loop. What do you guys think? I'll catch you in the next one. Tally ho.